Morning, guys. So it is currently 5. Let me check. It is currently 5:48 a.m. today, and I woke up thinking, what can I do? I want to be a lot more consistent on YouTube, and I was like, okay, we're in this crazy time of the world where we're self-isolating, social distancing, and quarantined and all of that good, not so good stuff. I wouldn't say good stuff. Yesterday, the Prime Minister just announced 3 weeks compulsory stay at home, no going out unless you have to do certain things. And to be honest, I have to go for my baby's immunization on Friday, and I'm kind of dreading that. But aside from that, we will be home. So I thought to myself, why not do a day in the life of a newborn and a new mom? I've always wanted to do this a lot earlier, but when I first gave birth, I just didn't want to pick up the camera all the time. I wanted to just enjoy that moment with my baby and just, you know, start taking in what it is to be a new mom. And then when I was starting to feel like, okay, I was getting there, unfortunately, life happened to me, my family, and I just was not in the space. I'm still not in that space right now, but I have to move on. Life goes on. I can't hold myself back, and you know, it's a very painful thing that's happened. But in this time of quarantine, in this time of my 1 year maternity leave, I need to keep myself busy. So I decided, you know what, I'm going to continue recording. I'm going to continue to be creative. I enjoy doing this. You know, I may not be getting the views and the likes and the comments that I think, you know, sometimes the numbers kind of encourage you, but I really enjoy doing what I do now, like recording content and editing. It makes me really happy. So I'm going to continue doing it. So I thought today, let's do a day in the life of a newborn and a new mom. I'm going to try to record every single thing I do today as much as I can. Currently, as I said, it was 5:40. I think probably it's be 5:49 or 5:50 right now. And baby boy just had a feed. He just finished sucking, and right now he's kind of trying to sleep. That's the way he likes to sleep. Like, once he's awake, he needs you to carry him on your shoulder and walk around. He doesn't want to sit down. He will start crying. He will start lamenting. You can only sit down probably once he's deeply asleep. I don't know if he's sleeping. No. Eyes wide open. Eyes wide open. So, as I said, oh God, my arms are aching me. I'm going to do a day in the life of a newborn. Today, we're self-isolating, social distancing. So, it's not as if we have anything major to do. But I had a couple of things that I wanted to do, which is, number one, we need a bath for baby boy. Ever since Momsi left, which was like a week and a few days ago, we've only bathed for him once. He's not going anywhere. The weather is still, it's getting cold. It's getting warm, but it's not like he's going anywhere. So we've only bathed for him once. Today will be the second time that daddy and I would do this thing called bathing, because he cries like he's not from River State. His father is a River State man. Yeah, a Calabari boy. You're crying like you're not from there. You're crying like you're from Ondo. You're Ondo like your mommy. He doesn't like water. Are you agree with me, Baba? So yes, I'm going to do this today, hopefully. And then I plan on making jollof rice. I don't know if I'm going to do that. But also, today I'm going to record my delivery story. I wanted to do this a long time ago, but I kept on postponing, but I'm finally going to do that today. I'm going to do my delivery story today. It's going to be exciting. I'm still thinking where to record it. I really don't have time to. This is where I usually record. Oh, sorry, baby. Sorry. Shh. Are you still hungry? Where is it, gas? I'll go get some. Fuck off. Sorry. So this is where I usually record. This is our dining area. This is where I usually do my videos. But as you can see, current situation right here. This is real life-ish. This is baby station right now. You can see we even have his pram. You can see we even have his pram that we did not take off. We did not disassemble. Is that the word I'm trying to find? So I'm probably thinking I may need to record in his room. I don't know just yet, but yeah, getting a bit cranky. Let me attend to him. Jesus loves you, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Need two children to hear me calls. They are weak, but he is strong. Are you praying? Yes. Jesus loves you. Yes. Jesus loves you. Yes. Jesus loves you. For the Bible tells me so. So I had to seek professional help to sing songs for baby boy. He's beginning to yawn, not yet sleeping, but I sought professional help. Yeah, that's party at 6 a.m. He likes when you dance and move around. So guys, all of that did not work out at all. He was still crying, he was still very fussy. I was walking up and down, tired, could not do it. So I decided to go the African routes. This is all we do in Africa. Nobody should come and say, hey, hey, he's on your back, hey, hey. The way he's on my back, hey, hey. They're also in front, you know? Yeah, so room is messy. But this is baby boy. Can I get him? This is baby boy on mommy's back. Okay, so now that he's sleeping, it's 6:21 already in the morning, and I'm still feeling sleepy. I did sleep well. He slept pretty long, I would say. He did sleep pretty long. Well, my husband had to work all throughout the night, almost throughout the night. He did work for long time at night, so I didn't want to wake him up to do his usual normal schedule that we do, because normally what I do is I feed him at night. Is that I bottle feed him, I pump and I put in a bottle. I'm exclusive, maybe I'm doing exclusive, so that is breastfeeding only, but I do pump and put in a bottle. So when I refer to bottle, it's not formula, it's breast milk. So it's either I give him a bottle or I feed him directly, and then after I do that, hubby then takes over, bobs him and puts him to bed, because hubby's he's quite good at putting this boy to bed, like dancing and singing and forming songs. He's I would actually say better than I am. So that's what we usually do, but because he was working all throughout the night, I didn't want to bother him, I didn't want to disturb him, so I let him, you know, just do what he was doing. And when he finally went to sleep, I decided to take over. Normally I will be the one sleeping, hope you'll be the one downstairs trying to put this boy to bed, but let me do it today because he didn't sleep properly. So I want to continue because I still feel sleepy. It's just 6:20. What did I say it was? 6:21, 6:22, 6:23. It's just 6:23 right now. There's no point rushing to start the day and then I start feeling ill, because what I usually notice is they always say sleep when the baby is sleeping, which is true, but I find that I don't get to do that because I'm like, I want to press my phone, I want to use my laptop, I want to watch TV, I want to do that, and then by the time you actually want to sleep or nap, it's already like evening. Like, and for me, once it's like 5-6, there's no point me napping, because once I nap, I'm not gonna sleep throughout the night, so there's no point. So I tend to like hold myself and kind of force that sleep not to come, and then I probably fall asleep and be like 9, which is quite early for me, or say 8 something. So what I'm going to do, I'm rambling too much. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to sleep, put this boy down, try to catch some sleep myself, probably wake up, say he's just fed, like say 5 something. He probably will be up like say 7, 8. Then I would get up and then fully start my day. So I will catch you guys when we wake up, because mommy is still feeling because mommy is still feeling sleepy. Feel tired, you know, when you don't sleep, you feel like you're about to be ill. I really saw coronavirus everywhere. It's like, hey, my body is paining me. Is it fever? I have sore throats. It's just like funny how you then get sore throats. Like, I have sore throats. Is it coronavirus? I'm coughing. Oh my god, it's not even funny. It's not funny. I'm recording. So the last clip I said, I showed you putting him down in his side sleeper, and that way are you coming down?
She needs to
babe, stay upstairs and sleep. And you have not slept.
I can sleep down there.
Eh? Me, I want to still sleep. Oh. And here's a big.
I'm not sleeping in the room.
Here's a big cold. Can you put on the this thing? So, I'm recording. As I said, so we're gonna sleep for like 2 hours. Wake up like say 8, right? That was about 6 something, almost 7. This is like 6:50 something, so it's almost 7 o'clock. That did not last for 10 minutes. I put the boy down, so he starts sleeping, and he starts to get real fussy with me. Carried him, gave him to nurse, but he still was not having it. So what I want to do now is I want to give him a bottle. I have a bit of milk here. Oh god, this is not gonna do anything. Really small. So when I pump, I don't pump excessively, like the way you watch, the way I see women on the way I see women online pump, they store a lot because of the fact that I don't have a deep freezer just yet. I want to be able to pump and have space to put the milk. Currently my fridge freezer is pretty small. I need space, so there's no space for that. So I don't pump in bulk. I usually pump once in a day. If it's a good day, I will pump twice, but I just pump once in a day, and then I breastfeed him for the rest of the day. So this is what is left from what I pumped yesterday. Let's see if this would satisfy my yoga. I've given him a bit of breast milk, but this one would just probably knock him out a little bit. Let me quickly run this one. So normally I'll give him 70, but I don't know what this would be. It's really small. So this is like 40. This is like 40. This is all I have, but I'm gonna give it to him because he just nursed. I just gave him some breast. I just nursed him, gave him milk straight from the group. So I'm going to give him this 30. Probably this would fill him up and make him sleep properly well. But no matter, I'm giving 70. That's fresh feed, not socks, just slept, woke up. Oh, oh my, this is starting. It keeps getting wider day by day. Very soon it'll be in two different studios.
Drastic restrictions on daily life to combat the spread of coronavirus. He warned that without a huge national effort, the NHS will not
finish. finish. Are we good now?
Yeah. First is to shop for basic.
Are we good now?
Medicine. We could also go outside for one form of exercise.
And see if I run one form of exercise.
All gatherings of
what has been described as a lockdown. I know how difficult all of that is, and I am not going to seek to sugarcoat it in any way. But these.
Finally, I had the opportunity to go to bed. Oh my god, after the last clip you saw of me changing my baby, I was so sleepy and he was so cranky, like he didn't want to sleep. And as I said to you, my husband didn't sleep throughout the night because he was working. So I was like, oh, let me be nice and keep all of this, you know, while he was trying to sleep. But then he came downstairs and instead of pressing his phone, I was like, nope, nope, nope. Then you don't want to sleep. Then I want to sleep. If you don't want to sleep, I want to sleep. So you take care of the baby. So that was how I used the Mobi wrap for my husband. And then we put baby in. And baby was crying initially, but he then later slept off. And I also slept off. That was around, probably say, 9, if I recall the time. That was like, let's say 9 o'clock, past 9. This is past 11. I just woke up. I just say just, not just, I woke up about 10 minutes ago, woke up, fed baby, and then baby is back to sleep now. I feel so much better. I feel rejuvenated. I feel like, you know, yes, I can finally get some rest. I'm beginning to talk too much. Let me go make breakfast. Girl is getting hungry. Actually 12:35 and I have not had breakfast. I've just had a small sip of water. I think the mistake I made was when I woke up initially in the morning, before I went back to sleep again, I should have eaten something. Even if it was golden moon or I drank tea or something, I would have had something in my system before I went back to sleep, but I didn't eat anything. So I've not eaten throughout the whole day. And I'm breastfeeding, and I fed my baby like 3-4 times and I'm breastfeeding. Not good, not good, not good. So I want to make breakfast or lunch at this point. It's going to be brunch before it's ready. So I'm going to do boiled Irish potato. I think I'm going to mix a bit of, is that sweet potato there? Because I know my mom bought some sweet potatoes before she left, but I don't know. I'm going to use do boiled potato, Irish potato and sweet potato, if there's sweet potato. And I'm going to boil some plantain and either fry egg, or we're just going to use stew. I don't know. I don't think I can be good at stir frying egg, but we may just use stew or fry egg. Hope you want me to fry egg. Not too sure just yet, but let's see how that goes. Where do I put you guys? Food is finally ready, and this is 1:40 in the afternoon. I'm just having, well, he's had breakfast, he's had golden one, so he's had something. I haven't had anything, and I'm breastfeeding. Food is finally ready, so we have potato, boiled potato, boiled plantain, egg, and chicken, and water and cheese. And every single time I want to eat, that's when Zion knows that he wants to wake up. I've been watching him now. I've sat down, I want to eat. That's when he knows he wants to wake up and suck. So I've just been here chilling, trying to feed baby here. I think I should pump, but we actually want to go for a walk. It's beautiful out there. A walk around our estate. We're not going anywhere crazy. You're allowed to take walks as long as it's you and somebody, the people you live in your house. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take what? Nothing. That's what we're going to do. We're going to go and take a walk around the estate. We need to bat for baby boy here. We meant to do that yesterday, but we didn't do that yesterday. I've just been here batting and struggling with my laptop here. I just got it, but when we were getting it, we got so excited that we didn't even check the specs of the laptop or anything. It has no memory card holder. Literally all it has is like earpiece holder there. I can show you. Holding Zion. It only has this for earpiece. And it has this for charging. I don't know, there are two of them, but so far so good. All I can put in it is a charger. And this is my husband's laptop. So what I do is, while I was recording, my memory card kept on telling me that it was full. So what I had to do was transfer the content on the memory card, put it on my husband's laptop, and then transfer that to my laptop. So I'm like, is that what I'm going to keep doing? The essence of getting the laptop now was to eliminate using my husband's laptop, so that when he goes to work, I'm not going, oh, there's no laptop to use and all of those things. Now I still have to use his laptop to send the file to my own laptop. Really annoying. So I've been trying to do that since, and then I've been feeling a bit, been having a bit of tummy ache, so I'm just a bit about it. But yeah, it's almost 4. I thought I was going to be able to cook and then record my delivery story, but I don't think I can do that today. Maybe tomorrow. If baby here was sleeping, I probably would have gone up to do that, but he's not sleeping, so there's no way I can do that. And we want to go for a walk, so we're just like, it's just like, yeah, baby, yes. So I don't know yet, but that's what we're doing. We're just here chilling, watching Netflix. So we are out of the house.
Did you lock the door?
Yes, going for a stroll. Honestly, I've not done what I wanted to do. I've not cooked, and I have not recorded the video that I wanted to record. But when hubby was like, let's go for a stroll, I was like, okay, sure, why not? Not necessarily feeling one, but thought it would be good just to go out and, you know, get that fresh air sort of. We've been indoors for quite a while, so we're just what was the last time I went out? Wednesday.
Yeah, Wednesday, yeah, we just went to the shop.
Yeah, okay. So we're just going for a walk around the estate, nothing crazy. We're allowed to go out as long as you're going out with... Why is she angry? As long as you're going out with somebody, people that you live in, you live with, sorry. As long as you're not going out with strangers or, you know, friends that come from a different place, you're allowed to go out. So we're just going out, taking baby out, get him all chilled with his, yeah, he's all chilled, all relaxed. So yeah, we're just out for the walk. I thought I'll be able to record, as I said, 20 times, but I think I'll do that tomorrow. I'm here for tomorrow. My battery is about to die, so see you guys when we get back in. But yeah, and funny enough, I'm wearing a leather jacket. Like, the weather is really good. I wish this whole corona thing was non-existent. Otherwise, it would have been a good time. No, you have to go back. We have to go there. It would have been a good time going out. Have you going to Nando's or eating outside? It would be really good, but unfortunately, we cannot. So yeah, about to shut my camera because battery's about to die. Bye, guys. So we are back from our stroll. It was really good. It was so good. Like, the weather was beautiful. I didn't even want to get back, like, home into the house. I was looking for ways that we can actually stay out. Like, I cannot wait. I just pray, God, please keep us, keep our family. Let this whole coronavirus thing just be over with already. Like, I cannot wait for the summer. Feels good already. I'm trying to multitask. Having some watermelon. I'm also pumping so my baby can find get something to eat, and I'm editing the vlog that I'm going to post tomorrow. As I said, I want this video to come up to be uploaded tomorrow, so I'm also trying to do that before baby boy wakes up. Oh, he's really shaking. So yeah, that's what I'm up to now. Done pumping. This is what I was able to get from each of my boobies. This is milk for baby. Yep, and he's awake right now. We're going to bait for him. Let me just pour this milk and put it where it's meant to be so I can put it in the fridge. Just using these bags from same metal. Today is 23rd of March, so this is 23rd of March 2020. This is bag two, this is bag one, whichever bag we pick up, it doesn't matter as long as the date is there. I think you can decide, you can store the milk in the fridge for 3 days. Some people say 3 days, some people say 4 days. It all depends. In the hospital ahead, everything is 666. So you can leave it out for six hours, put it in the fridge for 6 days, and put it in the freezer for 6 months. You hear different things, 6, 8, blah 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 blah. Well, as long as they don't pass 3 days, for me I'm fine, and they have never gotten to 3 days, maximum 2 days. So this is all I'm going to pump. So I'm just going to pack that, put number two first, put number one, put it here. Let's go to the fridge. And whatever you're doing, you want to make sure that, well, since I put it in the fridge and not in the freezer, try to put it right at the back so that the plastic touches the back of the fridge, which is like the coldest part, and it can really, really, really get chilled. That's what I try to do. So right now we're going to bath for baby. Connect this and put this back where it belongs. And right now we're going to bath for baby. You guys should wish me luck. Oh my god, I'm really proud of myself that I did this, you know, day in the life of a new mom and a newborn. Like, it's already 8:34 and I'm still recording. I really want this to like end. I'm going to end the vlog practically when we're about to go to bed, or around that time, or probably after I'm done with baby, and then I can end the vlog so I can continue editing. But I'm really proud of myself that I was able to, why am I showing myself halfway, that I was able to do this. So we can't wait for him just yet because I need this bathroom to be a bit warm. I just turned on the radiator for it to warm up, so another 5-10 minutes we will start bathing for baby. I prefer to do it here in the bigger bathroom because I can just, all I do is sit down and then put him on my lap. A lot easier than doing it in our own bathroom. And then this is his bath things that we use. So everything that we need is actually in here. Yep. So this is, I use the Aveeno Baby Daily Wash is what I use. And I use the Burt's Bee Baby Shampoo and Wash. So this is also a wash, but I use this one as a shampoo. And I also got the oil for the Burt's Bee, this Burt's Bee Baby, whatever. And I got this one for it too. So that is practically what I use to bathe for him. But I'm not holding the camera. That's what I used to bathe for him. So I'm just going to wait for about 5 to 10 minutes for this place to get a bit warm, and then we shall come and bathe for him. But I want to start using moisturizer on his skin. His skin is not as dry as it used to be. We used to use olive oil, but I know olive oil can be drying itself, so I kind of don't want to use olive oil. I've gotten Johnson's baby oil, but honestly I'm still very skeptical about using Johnson's product. I'm just not a fan of Johnson's product at all. Like, I'm not a fan of it. So I think I'll just still leave it there until he's, you know, until I'm kind of like convinced in my spirit that I should use it. But in one of the packs that I received from my Emma's Diary, because over here when you're pregnant you get Emma's Diary. I think I've explained this in my pregnancy video, so if you don't know about Emma's Diary, head up to my pregnancy video and you see me explain that. I got this as one of the free gifts that they give, the sample gifts. It's called Child's Farm, not sponsored or anything. And I just thought, I love the packages. I know this is like sample products and all of that, and there's a baby moisturizer in here, so I'm thinking I should start using this one just to moisturize his skin, and then I'll continue to use the olive oil for his hair. And this is actually vegan. It's a vegan product, really nice, newborn and upwards. I think I'm going to start using this. What do I say? It's mildly fragranced. I don't know why it has fragrance, but I'm going to use this one. And then it has the baby bedtime bubbles and it has the baby wash. But since I have baby wash, I'm not going to use this one now. I think today I'll start trying this particular one and just see how it works. If I like it, I probably will get a bigger size for it. I like a bigger size for it. I like the fact that it's vegan free. It seems really organic and the packaging is very pretty. Hi people. So this is the end of the vlog. Last I said that we were going to bath for baby, which we've done. He's cried, he's eating, and now he's sleeping. We too, we're just eating. Just had noodles and some smoothie for dinner slash lunch, because we've only eaten, this is the second meal of the day we've had, and it's about 11 p.m. already. Late night dinner. But I just thought I'd come and end the vlog here so that I don't have to wake up tomorrow morning as I think, oh, I haven't finished the vlog and things like that. I hope you guys really enjoyed a day in the life with me as a new mom and a newborn. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. To all my new moms out there, congratulations. You're doing a great job. I would love to hear your story. I would love to hear how you go about your day-to-day activities with a newborn, how you are multitask and, you know, just do stuff with a newborn, with somebody that was not in your life and is now in your life. Let me know how you know, do things, because I was not able to do everything that I wanted to do. Maybe I can learn a thing or two from you guys. And then once again, congratulations. You guys should not forget to subscribe, share, like, and please comment leave a comment in the comment section below. I really appreciate it. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.